Hello, I'm James Michael Tyler. We're here today in New York City with Matthew Stover, the author of Star Wars, Revenge of the Sith. Matthew, thank you very much for being with us today.
It's a pleasure. I'm glad to be here.
Most people would call this a novelization of the script. However, I know that you think of it as a novel in its own right. Can you explain the difference between those two?
Instead of simply translating the film into prose, I decided to try and make a companion piece to the film. So I deliberately sort of downplayed the physical details and the narrative in favor of the external narrative in favor of the internal narrative, and tried to focus on the characters' emotions, their psychology, their motivations, and literally how it feels to be a Jedi, how it feels to be Anakin Skywalker, faced with the extreme moral pressure, the choices that he's faced with, how it feels to be Obi-Wan Kenobi, helplessly watching his best friend teeter on the cliff of the dark side.
Matthew, what I find particularly interesting about your novel is how you have tied together the original trilogy and the prequel trilogy. How much license did Mr. Lucas give you to work with the expanded universe material?
I asked him how much I could change, how much of his dialogue I had to use, and he said that as long as I didn't change the action, I didn't change the sense of the scenes, I said, change whatever you want, just make it good.
To me, one of the most compelling parts of your novel is Anakin's fall and how you describe that. He falls because of love.
Yes, absolutely true. But after all, there is love and there is love. There is selfless love and there is selfish love. There's love that's about you and there's love that's about how I feel about you. And this is the crucial distinction that Anakin fails to realize in time. One of the things that we find in Revenge of the Sith is that the dark side is not tempting Anakin to anything. That Anakin is looking at the dark side and saying, that's what I want. And that was actually where Mr. Lucas went in the reshoot, where, and that I thought was the stroke of genius that is gonna make this film blow people's minds, and that I thought brought the book together and made it all just made it transcend what I had hoped it could be.
Anakin is the chosen one, the most powerful Jedi ever. But what about Obi-Wan Kenobi? I mean, how does he stack up in your book?
Obi-Wan is my favorite character. Obi-Wan has always been my favorite character. Obi-Wan is the reason I went to see Star Wars in the first place. And one of the really satisfying things about this book for me was the opportunity to bring Obi-Wan up. Because actually it's not me doing it, I should say. But I had the opportunity to write about it. It's Mr. Lucas who's doing it. It's his story. But it's his story where Obi-Wan steps up and takes his rightful place as really one of the pivotal heroes of the entire Star Wars saga. He's the ultimate Jedi.
The book is Star Wars, Revenge of the Sith by Matthew Stover. And fans, this is the book that ties all of the films together. And you can buy this at your local bookseller or just by clicking the link.